Ladies and gentlemen, good evening. This is the Board of Selectmen meeting of 8 September 2015. Tonight, we have a departmental update from Chief Osley of the Police Department. We've got two license, liquor license actions pending to discuss. Also discussing relocation of the TV studio from the present site at Smith Academy. Town administrator roles and responsibilities, some financial policies that have been in place for some years, but perhaps it's time to just take another look. Is this still what we need, or do we need to make any changes? Also, a brief discussion about our hazard mitigation plan and its update. An update on a number of ongoing activities, a variety of other matters. Any announcements?
I just have a couple, if I may. Oh.
Okay.
Or does the board have anything?
No. What if we said no?
The Board of Health and Council on Aging, this is just a reminder. We mentioned it at a previous selectmen's meeting. The Board of Health and Council on Aging on October 5th between 12:30 and 3:30 and October 29th between 6 and 8 p.m. will hold flu clinics, and that will be downstairs in the town hall. So again, that's Monday, October 5th from 12:30 to 3:30 and Thursday, October 29th from 6 to 8 p.m. And that is available to anybody, open to anyone over the age of 18. And in preparation of the holiday season, we're interested in anybody who is willing to volunteer with coordinating and volunteering time for the Luminarium. And that will be on the last Sunday before Christmas Eve, correct?
Yes.
But there is a lot of planning that goes into it. And it's just pretty much we're looking for somebody to coordinate the efforts. We do have people, the scouts, and other individuals, the fire department, who are very active in that whole day of events or evening. So anybody who is interested, we're anxious to hear from you, and we will have a notice posted on the town's website as well. And the upcoming fall festival is Sunday, October 4th, from 11 a.m. to 3 p.m., and there will be an antique classic car, truck and tractor show as well. And there's a parade starting at 10:30 from the American Legion. And we do have another meeting the end of this month, so we'll remind people. And this is available on the town's website as well, Kate? We can
no,
get it on there?
On the Facebook page.
On the Facebook page, okay. So information on the Fall Festival can be found on the town's Facebook page. Okay. That's all I have for announcements.
Another announcement, Ms. Jenny Williams.
Yes, I just wanted to update the board. I had met with you a few months ago. My race is coming together Saturday, October the 3rd. The 2-mile walk is at 9:30. The 10K is at 10 o'clock. And I'm just kind of reminding people if they want to sign up, they can do that on racewire.com or RunReg. We've got the volunteers lined up and everything for that. So I just wanted to kind of just let the board know where we were at with that, and I've been talking with both the police and fire, and we've got everything scheduled to go with that as well. So,
did you want to mention the purpose of the?
Yes, event? And all the proceeds of the race go to cancer research. So, so if you know anybody that wants to run, or there's a walk, or anything, or if you just want to volunteer your time to support the community, that would be great as well.
Are the signups right up until the? The event
yeah,
starts.
Yeah, online
that morning.
Registration will close on the 25th, but you can register for the race up until the morning of.
And they then could still come down.
Yeah. Okay. And then Friday we have open registration from 4 to 7 at the Congregational Church with a spaghetti supper and a raffle as well.
Oh, great. Yep. Thank you very much.
Yeah. Okay.
Thank you, Jenny.
All right. Thank you.
Next, some minutes.
Motion to accept the minutes of June 29th.
There's three sets.
You want.
Three sets. There are three sets. All three?
Yeah. From that evening.
So there's a motion to accept the executive session minutes. Three sets regarding contract negotiations with Mr. Belden, Mr. Genovese, and Mr. Mosley. Is there a second?
A second, not.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Is there a motion on accepting the minutes of October 4th, 2014?
So moved.
Second? Any discussion?
Yeah, what's the date on that? I'm sorry. I'm one behind you.
It's an old set of minutes.
No, I'm out.
Okay. Any other discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. All right, next we have a series of ongoing departmental presentations, and tonight Chief Mosley is here to talk about Police Department in town of Hatfield.
All right. Basically, I'm going to start off with some statistics. This is from January 1st, 2015 to September 1st, 2015. During the first 8 months of 2015, we received 1,050 calls for service compared to 1,008 calls during the same time last year. It's a 4% increase. But the difference being, of these 1,050, it could be anything from barking dogs on up. During the first 8 months of 2015, violent offenses were up 86% from this time last year. Mm. On some of the more minor offenses, they're down by as much as 64%. What this means for the police department is there are more man hours are being dedicated to investigative processes and less time to patrol functions. Due to the complex nature of these investigations, it has become a matter of necessity. Examples of these investigations are sexual assaults, aggravated assaults, child abuse and neglect, domestic assaults, and simple assaults, all of which have seen a sharp increase in the last calendar year. I know it seems a little alarming, but it's actually the entire nation's the same thing. So we're just kind of following the trend of the rest of the country. I don't know why the country has turned more violent, or they're just reporting them more, or what it is. But it's all over the country. Mm. And also, what's not representative in these numbers are the walk-ins to the station, street-level interactions, and phone calls. Station walk-ins include everything from pistol permits to legal advice, which some days are just constant. Street-level interactions include those things that officers happen upon, which they can handle in short fashion, usually just requiring a log entry. Direct calls to the private line or personal cell phones range from sometimes quite serious to simple matters requiring anything from an investigation to just a return phone call. And basically what it all boils down to as far as the statistics are concerned is we're busy. We're very busy, and it's not just any one kind of thing. It's like a slice of everything. And as I was going to say, statistics are fine, but one of the things that makes our department distinguished is the people that work for it. We try to be community-oriented with everything we do. We get involved with events in town and also take it on ourselves to do things as a department. We do a community breakfast each year. We participated in the Ice Bucket Challenge. We have a scholarship for high school seniors who plan to attend college for criminal justice. We try to make ourselves part of the community with our actions. During training, when a new officer comes on board, they are taught that everyone they deal with deserves respect. Sometimes we are sent on what might seem like a trivial call, but they are anything but trivial to the caller. They wouldn't have contacted the police department if they didn't think it was important. Because of this, giving anything less than complete attention to the matter is unacceptable. Since I started 33 years ago, I have done this to the best of my ability and have insisted that everyone working for the department does the same thing. It has always worked in the past and continues to be one of the reasons the town of Hatfield should be proud of their police department.
Staffing levels?
We're right up to where we should be.
Okay.
We're just finishing training on our last recruit. He'll be doing shadow work, taking a second cruiser and having the evening guy follow him around, more or less on his own. So as of right now, we've got all the people we really need. We could hire one more, but it's unnecessary at this point. So staffing is good.
How many in total?
Well, we got 11 people, because our total normally would be 12.
Okay. How about, you mentioned training?
We do twice a year firearms qualification. We do first responder CPR each year. And any of the guys, they go for individualized training. If anybody wants to go to a training, that's fine.
Okay.
I, through the Mass Chiefs Association, I have us signed up to do in-service training online. So we do the in-service training too.
How about your new office? How's that working out?
It is such a breath of fresh air to be able to look out a window and see something besides whether it's day or night. And being in the basement, it just was terrible. And this thing is nice over here. I thank everybody for doing that for us, because we needed it badly.
What do you see as your top issues? Maybe the top three?
Right now, we're in a good place. We don't really need anything.
Okay.
We've been fortunate to get some money in from that concert we have each year, so we're able to kind of, if we need something, we more or less just go get it. I mean, nothing expensive, but, you know, if we needed a computer for something. Mm-hmm. We got two new tough pads for the cars, for the computers. And we've gotten some nice stuff with that concert money, so hopefully this year we'll do well.
Okay.
That's October 17th, I believe
17th,
it is.
Yeah.
So.
Do you, you might not have numbers going too far back, but have you noticed that there's a steady incline? Like you said, there's about a 4%. Well, yeah, about a 4% increase.
Every year,
it seems to kind of creep up.
And it seems about like that much each year. It does go up every year.
Yeah.
Not a whole lot, but it does go up.
Yeah.
You know, and it's not, this is the first year that we've had the violent type crimes with sexual assaults, et cetera, go up as much as this one did. And I don't know whether it's an aberration or.
Yeah.
Hopefully it's not a trend.
Right.
But yeah, it goes up pretty much the same. It goes up mm-hmm. each year, but not a lot.
Okay.
How many of the staff would you consider to be full-time, including yourself, obviously? Three.
Yeah, me, Mike, and Clint. And the rest of
you don't see a need for, at this point?
I have thought long and hard about that, and the only thing we could do with a third guy is kind of fill him in, and then that would eliminate all part-time guys, which I kind of don't want to do.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so.
Gives you a lot of flexibility.
Yeah, it gives us, it does.
The thing is, now is the time to think about that and to plan, because we'll be going to budget pretty soon. What, November, December?
Yeah, well, capital budgeting starts in December.
And I have thought quite a bit about it. I hesitate at this point to do that with our hours, because we're only working obviously 16 hours a week.
Mm-hmm.
If we were working three shifts, it'd be a different story.
Yeah.
But I mean, I've been here forever, and I don't see any need for that third shift.
That's fine. Yeah, we trust your judgment.
Yeah. As long as we got those guys with the blue cruisers up there,
yeah,
you know, we should be okay as far as that goes.
Okay. Good.
Anything else?
No, I'm good.
Thank you very much, Tom. Appreciate
thanks,
what you
thank
all
you,
do.
Thank you, Chief.
All
right.
Yeah, thank you.
Take care.
See ya.
Yep.
Let me take one out of order unless someone has an issue. This is the Food Bank of Western Mass asking for a liquor license for an event on the September 25th. Is there a motion to approve the application of the Food Bank of Western Mass for a function at the Hatfield Lions Club Pavilion on 27 September? It's a fundraiser for the Food Bank.
So moved.
Second.
Sorry.
I think we got it on the table and we got it voted in.
All in favor?
Aye.
All right, let's take that one.
Sorry,
off.
Brian.
No.
This next one might take a little more time, and I'm not sure we're going to close on it, but at least maybe get a way to move forward. This concerns a liquor license swap. Last April, we had a hearing between two parties in to request a transfer of their liquor license, their respective liquor licenses. One party owed town taxes. The board moved to approve the swap contingent upon resolution of the tax issue with the town. And further, the town individual's attorney was going to work with our tax title attorney, and the funds that would have been exchanged between those two parties would have gone to the attorney, and the attorney in turn would convey them to the town to pay tax that one of the parties was in arrears on. Subsequently, the state had an issue with the taxes regarding the other party, but that has been arranged, so that's no longer an issue. The original transfer request was processed, was approved by the state. However, there's yet to be any resolution of the tax issue with the town, and I guess the question on the table, or issue on the table for us to chat about, is how to proceed. Would you come down forward, please? We have with us tonight our town collector, treasurer, to help us discuss this matter. And the plot thickens in that originally, we were only talking about taxes due for what we thought was just 14, and now there are taxes due for 15 as well. We're just doing a little background on this swap and the tax issue and trying to get some traction on a way forward.
You'll see I highlighted in yellow in the right column all the way down at the bottom is the total. Through October 1st, which was the date that Attorney Berenson gave me. And, that includes legal fees through August 31st, so that's why I highlighted plus legal and redemption fees. I would plan on, at least another $750 on that, $750 to $1,000.
Excuse me. Could I just ask for clarification? October 1st of what year? 2015?
15, yes.
Okay, so that's the total amount owed?
Yes, it is.
Okay, by the party. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. But in terms of what we're discussing, it only has to do with arrears.
Well,
right?
Well, this is
this
arrears.
Is all
this is arrears.
In arrears. We're in fiscal year 16 now.
Right.
Okay.
So the party was in arrears.
Right, so the interest is on what's in arrears, correct?
The interest in the if you're talking about the gray column, that's the treasurer's tax title interest at 16%.
Now.
Yeah, the third column over of figures is the collector's committed interest at the time of turnover to the treasurer's books. But on the collector side, everything is kept by fiscal year. On the treasurer side, a tax title account is kept as a whole. And there's no breakdown. I mean, you'll see that we post the subsequent year. We're adding it in its entirety as it's shown on the instrument. But as far as our balance goes and what we're paying off, the treasurer's interest gets paid in full first before, and it starts, then the sewer lien, then the water lien, any betterments, and then the committed interest from the collector, and then principal. So, it needs all the treasurer's tax title interest for all years is paid, and then you move to the next.
Right.
Okay. Thank you.
Well, so the only leverage we have, then, is actually the ability to force the issue about collecting what is owed the town. And that is the leverage lies within the license. Am I correct on that?
Yes. And, you know, in order for redemption to occur, what you see on the spreadsheet is what needs to be satisfied.
Okay, and that's the last column?
Correct.
Okay.
The last column.
Yeah. What's on the bottom there?
With the last of the legal fees.
Thank you.
And the redemption fee is $75.
Mm-hmm.
You can see the month of August, legal fees were $495, and I would anticipate those going up if there was actual a redemption, because there's going to be more work involved by the attorney to prepare that.
So we still have to approve a local license?
Correct.
Correct.
Correct. And the board did vote to approve the swap, the licenses, contingent on the...
Satisfying the Hatfield tax...
That's correct. That is correct.
Now, at the time we did that through the fiscal year 14 issue, because that was in April.
Yes, it
However,
was.
Conditions have changed. Mm-hmm. Now we're already into 15. Fiscal year 16, and we have fiscal year 15 due.
Right.
As well.
15 subsequents have already been turned over from the collector's books to the treasurer's tax title books. So now it is part, you know, ideally you want that to occur prior to June 30th, and it did.
So one option would be to go back to the attorney representing the party to say that we're prepared to issue the local licenses
mm-hmm.
associated with this swap, contingent on satisfying the currently outstanding amount due in taxes.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And that's consistent with how we've treated others in terms of their licenses. We've always withheld approval of the licenses or issuance of the license until they've satisfied their local taxes.
Correct. Again, it's the only leverage we have.
We should be contacting the collector's office to see if there are any outstanding taxes
older than 1 year, correct?
12 months, at least 12 months, and that is usually done in September, beginning October. Liquor license renewals are done during the month of November, so you should receive a letter in August, September, asking for a list of those licensees that have okay. taxes outstanding 12 months or greater.
Okay, and just so you know, running the list would take about 15 seconds. It's very quick. Mm-hmm. So, you know, it's something that, you know, once it was given to you so you could see it, you could easily get an updated list on a weekly basis, you know, for people who are making payments.
And then what we normally do is we would include a letter to the license holder with their renewal application, making them aware that that those taxes need to be paid in order for their license to be renewed.
Well, let me, I'm sorry, do you have a question?
Okay. Go ahead, Jeff.
Let me translate what I said into a motion, or ask if anybody would make the motion. That is there a motion to go back to the individual's attorney and or the individual advising that we are prepared, the Board of Selectmen is prepared to issue the local licenses subject to satisfying the currently outstanding tax liability.
Is that enough of leverage that we're giving off here? Because, you know, do we wait another year?
No, well, there's no...
If nothing happens, then we... What recourse do we have?
If nothing happens, we'll be foreclosing on this property in approximately 45 days.
Okay, and so that sends the control of the license then, I'm asking, I don't know this, okay, back to the town without question, or is there another intermediary there, the attorneys for the, what would be the defendant, or what? I mean, how are we going to not so much retain our leverage, but enforce it?
Well, the licenses
we're only
are
talking
issued.
About the license right now.
Right. We will not.
We will not let up on the tax title, the collection efforts. That would continue if it didn't get satisfied in conjunction with this.
And just one suggestion in the wording for the motion is that I would, as opposed to, you know, prior tax obligation, just to say, you know, redemption of the tax title, which it will always include whatever's in the treasurer's tax title, even if, you know, this occurs, you know, more time goes by.
Well, really, I think the difference between our original motion months ago.
I was going to come back to that.
Oh, all right. And this one is really, we're sort of adding the most recent taxes, because the other one did in fact say, we're not issuing a license until we get the back taxes, but that was only through 2014.
And the other one dealt only with through 14.
Right.
Because the fiscal year 15 had not concluded.
Correct.
And therefore we could not include that amount because it wasn't overdue. Because we're still in the fiscal year.
Exactly.
Conditions have changed now in that that fiscal year has already passed and there's an additional amount due that has not been satisfied.
I just wanted to clarify that we're really basically adding more tax years to our original motion.
Yes, but time has passed.
Because, right. Okay, we're saying the same thing. I just wanted to.
So what prevails at this point is the revised motion.
Agreed.
Well, the prior one, forget. Now we're going to add more to it.
Right. Exactly. Yes, in a nutshell.
Yeah, I mean, seriously.
It's a lot of money.
Yeah, really. A lot of money. And at some point, it's going to have to be settled.
No, we will. This is one way. There are other ways that our tax attorney can handle. So have you made that motion?
Yes, if Key has it, I made it.
All right, is there a second?
Could you repeat the motion, please, Key?
Moriarty moved to go back to the individual's attorney advising you are prepared to issue the local license subject to satisfying current outstanding tax liability. And then Ms. Bertrand suggested we add redemption of tax title rather than liability.
I'll second that.
All right. Any other discussion?
Okay.
All in favor?
Aye.
Okay. But the other thing I think we talked about earlier, these licenses expire soon, right? So another option we have regarding licenses is not to reissue the license.
Right. Okay. So when would that take place?
Was it November?
And is it automatic?
Is it November?
Their current licenses expire December 31st.
Oh, December 31st.
Okay. And
the
so
current
at that point,
right.
It's over and done with.
Yeah.
Could
as
be.
Far as that's, could be. I'm sorry.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you, Jeff.
Could be.
And it is something that we would strongly consider, to put it mildly.
Sure.
Okay.
Thank you very much.
Thanks.
I
appreciate it. And you're going to, as routine, provide town administrator those lists of outstanding taxes?
Again. When I notify her. Yeah, I have to notify her in writing. Requesting.
So we know before we act on licenses. Mm-hmm. Thank you very much. Appreciate it. Marlene, did you want to cover 4?
Fire chief search update. Selection committee has been notified of their charges, and actually they're going to be holding their first meeting, I believe it's September 29th, and they will receive copies of the resumes to review, and they will organize. They'll meet in executive session on September 29th.
Excuse me.
Okay. DPW director is not here. Just a couple items. I don't have the full report from him. He's had to be away for 2 days. We're talking about the water improvement project, and we're still waiting for the Department of Transportation to give us the permit to cross the railroad. Recall that the ownership of the railroad changed from whatever the company, I forgot what company, what it was, Railroad 2, Department of Transportation. Sidewalk improvements, we submitted a reschedule on to Department of DCHD.
An extension.
An extension for completion, and we, I've heard nothing awaiting on their blessing. We don't expect any issue. We owed the Department of Environmental Protection a series of reports. First one due in August on their inspection. Again, that was submitted timely, mm-hmm. but no feedback as yet. And the main issue for the August report had to do with the license of one of the individuals, and we outlined a way ahead as to how we plan to handle that. Disposal plan for the bricks on Elm Court in the DPW storage area. That area can't be used as a landfill or long-term storage area. It's only for short, can only have materials there for ongoing projects. And I have yet to hear what the plan is. Public library roof, they have some leaks. I know they're talking to some vendors about permanent repairs. I don't know just exactly where that is. We did submit timely two Mass Works projects, one to extend the water transmission line from the Brockway Smith area as far as it will go over the Mill River and up to higher ground on Chestnut Street and Gore Avenue area. It's going to be a couple months before we hear back whether that was approved or not. And then the other one was more water and sewer improvements on West Street. And then I think DPW is pressing ahead with Steel, I forget what the name of the company is, with the Prospect Street Court Bridge, converting that to
Right, there's...
Am I clear here? He is going to revisit topic number 5 through 11 for our benefit.
Sure.
If we have any questions.
Sure, absolutely,
meeting.
Yeah.
I just want to make sure he includes it in his presentation.
Sure.
Thank you, because I do have questions.
Okay. If you do, why don't you ask him ahead of time, and he can be sure to address your issues.
It part of it. Oh,
yeah.
Sure. Yeah, that's not a problem.
Town Administrator?
Okay, thank you. Just some quick updates. The items that are not numbered, I don't have any additional documents or handouts. But NextAmp Solar Project, the Board of Assessors have notified me they will meet with us on September 29th at our meeting to discuss or start discussions regarding the payment in lieu of taxes agreement. The relocation of the Hatfield Cable TV studio, I have been in contact with a couple of contractors.
Just one comment on NextAmp did provide the board with some suggested numbers.
They did, and that was
For a pilot. However, all the Department of Revenue recommendations are that you don't set specific numbers. Rather, you develop a formula to use as opposed to numbers. And an agreement is far more than just the formula. It has to do with provisions for decommissioning, for adding additional panels, taking off and removing panels, abandonment, all that needs to be covered down in this.
That's the conversation we'll have with the assessors,
right.
Correct?
That's right.
Meet with them.
Thank you.
Back to the cable TV studio, I met with a contractor last week, and there were some items that were brought up that had not been discussed or brought to our attention previously. There is a fire strobe located in that room that the cable studio would be relocating to. And if we're putting up a divider wall, that strobe light will not be able to, you know, go through the divider wall. It'll only have an impact on the side of the room that the school essentially would be using. There is also an emergency light in that room. And again, that would not assist the side of the room that we would be using for the studio. So we're looking at additional costs to put in a fire strobe and an emergency light. So costs are greater than what we had anticipated.
What's our working estimate at this point? Or do we have?
I'm still waiting for another quote to come in. So until I have that one.
Well, do we have a range or rough around?
Well, originally we were looking at about 19,000, roughly.
So about 20 grand.
Yes.
Whose financial responsibility is that? Is that the school department?
Well,
or is that ours?
The school has made it clear that they do not intend on covering any of the costs. And that's.
That brings up, just for folks, rewind for a second. We're talking about an area at Smith Academy that had been used and dedicated for our.
The former band room,
Our cable TV operation, and there's a little studio there. Since then, the school has decided to reclaim a certain amount of that area for use for their band activities, to support their band activities. They're taking care of the costs regarding their own portion.
Close to $200,000.
$200,000, but expect us to eat the cost of relocating so that they can take the space.
Through the revenues that are generated with cable TV and Comcast.
Correct.
Well,
right.
I'm just so people understand where the expectation is.
Okay, none of this ever went through capital planning, but that's another issue.
Right.
In any event, given the costs over 20 grand, town administrator just put on the table, maybe we relook at where we go for the long term instead of spending 20,000 and then maybe get evicted again, look to some other place that we own and control and relocate the studio there.
Right. I'm raising the question as to whether we want to incur those costs should the school at some point in the future have a need for that entire classroom or area.
And one, have you talked to John Novak?
John and I have been in touch.
I guess the critical piece here is how soon must he relocate in order to function, and or can he defer?
Well, he has already relocated the equipment. Comcast has been over there and relocated the cables, the wiring. He just doesn't have the setup of a studio. It's pretty, that room is still open.
Mm-hmm.
But there is the cost of putting a divider wall in, including insulation, and then there would be a partition, a wall, to close off the studio. There would be a door.
Is there any possibility?
Well, I should say there's a studio and then there's the control room. The control room would be closed in.
Is there any possibility of moving everything we have to adjust to within the confines of town hall?
Well, that's what we're.
And be done with it.
Well, that.
So we got a reversal of the situation. Yep. We have ownership of the site and we have ownership of the equipment.
Mm-hmm.
And then we don't answer to anybody but townspeople in general. And they'd have to see us at town floor.
Right?
Excuse me.
And that was the original suggestion of the school department.
Yeah, okay.
Which was.
Long before I was on the board.
Well, before you were on. And then it sort of came as discussions were had. It was the feeling of some was that, well, the school wanted to reclaim that space where the studio was because they needed a larger band room. And in order to try to work together, we said, well, why don't we see if the studio and the control room will fit in the old band room rather than just say, we're taking it over, see you later.
Mm.
So the idea was to work collaboratively so that nobody felt that they were kind of getting booted,
Right. Quite
frankly.
Right, the superintendent.
But it
was,
would,
if
I personally have thought from the beginning that this would be the location that might make more sense, since this is where, I don't know the exact percentage, but the majority of filming takes place, other than maybe town meetings. So I just wanted to make sure everybody at home understood that, you know, this was a try to work together thing.
Absolutely.
And now the studio is taking on a life of its own through nobody's
exactly.
fault.
Exactly. That's.
It was originally said, oh, this is going to be
yes.
a few thousand dollars yes. to put up some yes. walls. And then it turned into the electrical. And now you're talking about
right.
fire
the
department.
The more we engage in discussions right. and, you know, prevailing wages and
yes.
costs, it has. It's taken on a whole
so,
new.
I guess we would need the cable department and others' input as to what they think makes sense. I mean, there's no way of predicting the future that right. that space would ever be needed again. I mean, I'd like to think it wouldn't. I don't know how long that the studio's been in the back there. I mean, quite some time. But
yeah.
the band has become so popular and so big and needed the additional space. So.
Let me be very clear. I don't have any problem
whatsoever
with the expansion of the band facility.
Right. Mm.
All I'm trying to do is propose that we look long-term.
Right, absolutely.
And to me, the long-term consideration necessitates seriously looking at transferring everything that is associated with the cable TV situation
right.
To Town Hall.
And, that
and
was
is
the thought,
that feasible?
That was a thought that crossed my mind. Maybe we should be looking to the future.
Well, we shouldn't give up whatever John needs to support town meeting over there. I mean, that's, or unless he could just simply tape the whole thing and that's all he'd need.
Well, I believe town meeting is recorded. I don't believe that's
nothing
televised
live.
But I will confirm that with
well, then,
him, but I
think
believe
you're right,
it's,
Marlene,
it's
but
recorded.
I'm not positive. I think it is.
Well,
it's tough to have this conversation without
recorded.
John here.
Yes.
But I will say this. That is the only meeting, for the most part, that gets recorded at Smith Academy, is town meeting once
correct.
A year. And the, if there's a show being taped.
Correct.
Everything else, all the meetings are here.
Right.
So
no, I asked that
so,
this be put on here, and I know John was going to be here.
Right.
I just wanted to get a sense of
sure.
If the board is agreeable that we'll have Marlene and John
yeah.
take a look at options here.
Makes sense
for
long-term.
Example, here on the old stage area, clean that out, and is that a possibility right there to
right.
to set up
take
shop?
A look at what our options are. Now, we have incurred some
and
costs
those
with
costs?
Comcast with the recabling.
I understand.
And as costs are increasing, I thought maybe we need to just hold for a bit here and relook at this.
Is that an agreeable approach to take a look at another option here?
Oh,
I agree with Pat.
Yeah.
Let's do what one and done.
I don't see how we cannot do that.
Good.
I mean, and make a long-term
right.
decision.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So I'm not sure I can rephrase my observation no into a question.
So is there a motion to have the town administrator and head of our cable broadcast assess relocating the TV studio to Town Hall.
Retaining the ability to tape at the high school or the elementary school. If there's anything
okay.
that has to be dealt with there, so we don't have to come back and revisit it. I'll make that motion.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Okay, good. We'll take a look at it. Next one, Marlene.
Financial policies have been reviewed with the town accountant and the town treasurer. And at this time, there are not any significant changes or additions, but I do encourage us to review these annually. The only change I noted, that was on page, no, it's not in red. On page 2, on the middle of the page or 3/4 of the way down, self-supporting operation guidelines, it should read the fire chief. It currently reads the fire chief shall annually recommend to the, it says the ambulance manager
right.
shall annually recommend. That was in red, and I don't know the copy I have. It's very faint. But I'm just recommending that it be changed. We change that to the fire chief, since the ambulance department is under the control of the fire chief.
We developed these some years ago. The Board of Selectmen approved them. We then coordinated them with the Finance Committee, who also agreed with them. It's a good management practice to have your financial policies documented. Agencies that do financial ratings, like S&P, look to see if the community has, in fact, documented its policies, and I guess you get points for having done it anyway. And this was the product, and I just thought it would be appropriate to put it back on the table. And I asked Marlene to coordinate with the treasurer and accountant to see if they'd take a look at it and had any other suggestions that we needed to do anything differently. And so for the moment, everyone's seems to be on board as written, except this edit you're talking about.
Right, guideline number 2 under okay. Self-supporting operations.
Okay, great.
But anything we do, either together or separately, I would think would necessitate us taking care of that before the end of this calendar year, so that we can move forward with any revisions mm-hmm. as we develop mm-hmm. town meeting, the articles, and so on and so forth. Mm-hmm. So. Is it appropriate to put in a time frame for this?
Oh, we've already...
Or we just assume that's going to be taken care of, the revisions, a review of it, and so on and so forth?
We've already done the review.
When was the review done?
We've had the treasurer look at it the past few weeks, okay. the town accountant the past few weeks, new town administrator the past few weeks have all looked at it, and they concur that it's... Mm-hmm. appropriate, and they had no significant changes. The only one was an editorial because we combined ambulance and fire.
Well, do you not think it might be feasible for us to meet with the Finance Committee? And
we already did that, and they approved these.
Okay, and then we revised those. Not revised those, but we read through to make sure that everything was within the status that we want it to be.
Right.
Do we know that's true of the Finance Committee?
No, that is not true.
Upon that's what I'm suggesting we do, is right. We just simply sit down sure. and chat with them and say, this is our okay. strong recommendation, and be done with it. And everybody's on board.
Yeah, we're not looking for their approval. We're looking for their coordination. We're responsible for the policies. The Board of Selectmen is.
At the conclusion of the audit and upon receipt of the management letter, I had suggested or recommended that we review these. You know, we should be reviewing them annually. Right. And so I sat down with the town accountant and the town treasurer. And the only recommended change at this time is on page 2, right. Self-supporting operations. But I understand what you're asking.
We can refer to...
We can
Mr. Williams, chair of the Finance Committee, for any suggested changes or additions?
I mean, just to be clear, this is what they're using now, the Finance Committee.
This is what we're using.
Well, this is what we're using, but this is what they've already seen
yes.
in the past.
Yes.
This is because we're doing our review,
right.
as we should do yearly.
Right.
We want them to be part of that, as
right.
part of the financial team.
This was
these
policies were established by the Board of Selectmen yep. and reviewed with the Finance Committee.
Right.
And Finance Committee. Yeah,
it's not a new document, is the bottom line.
Right, it is not.
Okay.
So it has already been reviewed by both boards?
Yes, previously. Yes. But this we're just doing like a periodic update.
I'm trying to get a handle on when. Did I miss something or did I?
In 2000, at the top.
A few years ago.
Right up top.
Right. That's what I wanted. That's why I wanted to make sure that. Yeah.
That's why I asked to bring it back to the table. It's been some years since it was.
Okay, so now what are we proposing to do with this approved as policy of August 26th, 2008?
It remains, and we're going to have the Finance Committee take a look at it, and if they have any suggestions, we'll discuss them with them.
Okay, all right. I was just thinking we could do it beforehand and then be done with it, and we're
yeah.
both boards are on tack as far as where we go forward from this point, rather than them reviewing it and then having to come back for another meeting with us if there are questions or whatever. It seems like a waste of time. Just do it one time with both of us there, give them the material in advance, they read it thoroughly, as they always do.
Well, we can give it to them in advance. They already have it, actually. They could review it, discuss it, and if they have any proposed changes or suggestions in our subsequent session with them, we can resolve it.
That didn't come out before.
Okay, Marlene?
Okay, I will send them, send the policy to the finance. Any questions? Okay. At our previous meeting, we had reviewed the posting for a disabled commuter appointment to the Franklin Regional Transit Advisory Board, and there was the question raised as to what the responsibilities are of that appointee, and I have confirmed with FRTA that the responsibilities and duties are the same as all members of the FRTA. And we have posted that on the town's, did I give that to you? I'm not sure if I did now. I know it's posted here in the town hall. And if it's not already on the town's website, we will get it posted. But if there is anybody that's interested in appointment to the FRTA as a disabled commuter appointment, please contact us at the town hall here and we'll submit your name. Any questions on that?
No. I just, for the record, I've received no information whatsoever from them regarding anything.
You have a meeting on the 17th.
Of September.
Yeah. Send one of your letters.
Did that message go?
You.
No, it didn't. I didn't get it.
I will share a copy with that.
Okay, thank you.
It's in a letter you have.
That was in communication that we had received a few weeks ago.
Okay. Thank you.
Okay.
I shall put it in the book.
You're welcome. The Emergency Management Planning Committee has a vacancy. It's the communications position that was previously held by Carrie Gaughan. Carrie is a member of the Board of Health, and she is on the emergency management, filling the health position, which had been held by Ed Lesko.
Can I ask, is the communications position like the PIO, the public information officer?
Yes.
Type thing, or is it someone concerned with communications, like IT, like phones, radios, compatibility, all that kind of stuff?
It's the public information officer.
Public information officer, okay.
So I'd like the board to recognize that there is a vacancy and we can have that position posted.
So move.
Second.
All in favor, aye.
Aye.
Also, the Emergency Management Planning Committee has completed the steps needed to update its hazard mitigation plan. And a public hearing was held on September 3rd. And all the changes, information will be made to the draft. A draft will be provided to the Board of Selectmen. And then it will be submitted to FEMA, Federal Emergency Management Agency, and they will approve it. Once they approve it, the town will be notified. And I understand that can take anywhere between 4 and 6 months for FEMA to approve it.
Okay.
Could I ask you a question on the previous topic, just for the people at home? So, if anybody's interested in the Emergency Management Planning Committee as the communications person, who would they contact to just find out more information about it? If they wanted to get some facts, maybe. Would it be you or the fire chief or Cindy Doty?
Fire chief or Cindy Doty.
Okay. Just to, you know, if they had questions and wanted some clarification before they signed up for it. Okay, thanks.
Cindy is the director of the fire, but emergency management is under the fire chief.
Right, okay.
And I'm certainly available too. Okay. Anybody could contact me.
Sure. Thank you.
You're welcome. The next item is to review the role and responsibilities of the town administrator. We've been talking about this for several weeks, and so you have in your packet a draft with a list of of those roles and responsibilities, and I haven't had a discussion with anybody, but I know that Jeff and I were preparing this, working on this list, as stated at the previous meeting. But if any other board members want to see something added or have questions about an existing item on that list?
I could be quite candid here. I think this is extremely extensive for one person to deal with. And I know Marlene is quite capable of dealing with it, and she is the kind of person that wouldn't say anything about a concern. So I'm just trying to speak up here. I myself was overwhelmed with the expansion of the whole scenario. And I think the board should seriously look at dealing with that in terms of getting somebody to be able to, even on a part-time basis, Marlene was comfortable with, to function accordingly. Our current staff should not be, we can't keep handing this stuff over when we know in our minds and our hearts that it's just not appropriate. We want a smooth-running ship, or whatever you want to call it. What do we got? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Oh, there's
six.
Much more than this. This is not a duty description. This is...
It's a breakdown of her overall...
Kind of overall
responsibilities.
Correct.
Right.
What's the difference between that and duty?
Well, it's...
The basic question is, do we hold her accountable in terms of job description and evaluation for... What's at least 20 to 25 different...
Actually, most of this has not changed in some years.
Excuse me.
The only thing... there's one thing that's not on here. And I forgot to put it on. The licenses role and liquor licenses and other things like that. What I did put on here, and I want to highlight because I'm not trying to hide it on that list, is supervise the town accountant. And the notion there is to get a better handle on, as you know, we've had some issues here, well documented in the audits, get a tighter handle on our financial management structure. And right now we have an elected, potentially at some point in the future, like other communities, to become an appointed collector, treasurer combined. We have the accountant, and we have the town administrator. And kind of putting that team together, I think would be very helpful in avoiding some of the pitfalls and problems that developed over the last year. And I think one piece of this could be, and we incrementally move that way, is you're putting the supervision, a closer supervision than perhaps one of us can provide, over the town accountant in the hands of our town administrator. I think it's just one step of tightening up that whole financial management structure. I mean, she does it as more as a practical matter as opposed to being formally assigned. She is the one working with the town collector and town treasurer. She is the one working with the town accountant on the financial matters.
I work closely with them, and we generally meet once or as twice a month if needed, just to review finances and any issues.
I don't see any problem with that. The problem I see is that people do not clearly understand
the scope.
The scope of your responsibilities and who is responsible to whom.
Right, and that's another reason for doing this as well.
Yeah, that's fine. That's fine. It clearly streamlines the process.
There is one thing I wanted to add to that first, and that gets to the interface with the other staff. Yes, the fire chief still works for us. Yes, the police chief works for the board. Yes, director of DPW works for the board, but I was thinking of rephrasing this first top line item, represent the Board of Selectmen in day-to-day town operations, plural, internally and externally, to include directing town staff on behalf of the board. to make it clear that town administrator is not acting as an independent agent. Town administrator is there as the face of the Board of Selectmen day to day because we're not there. And to make it, to get over this hurdle, well, we work directly for the board versus, folks need to start thinking about working as a team. And the town administrator is there kind of day to day as our representative and relaying instructions or decisions that we've made or gathering information for us from the various staff. I think it just needs to be very clear what her role is. Yeah, it's a big job. No question.
Tell me about it.
Well, we don't have to close. I mean, as an operating piece, as a piece of work in progress, if other folks have more things.
This is just being put out there. Yeah. This is a
and
draft.
And I think that's fine.
Okay. We can
what
continue.
We need to do is we need to go through it.
Yes.
And with a fine tooth comb, and then deal with it effectively as we transmit that information to other staff members.
Okay.
So that everyone clearly understands that the chain of command is this, 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 and this. And you are the person for the Board of Selectmen. You're our eyes and ears out there. I don't want to meet with 10 or 12 or 15 different people. I shouldn't have to. And if that workload is so substantial, which may very well be the case, then one of the things we have to look at, I believe personally, is the expansion of your department as such, even if it's a half-time person. I mean, was my intent.
It's important to me that the Board of Selectmen and myself are comfortable with this list.
Yeah.
And most importantly, I want to make sure that if the board is instructing me or directing me to communicate, whether it's with a resident or a department head, and then if the selectman or a member of the board does the same thing, I do have concerns about that.
We don't want to step on each other's toes.
Right, exactly. Yeah. So I want to make sure that this is laid out, that the board and myself are comfortable with how their responsibilities are, I guess, distributed.
In fairness, let me take just 30 seconds and let me read some of these. Mr. Gaughan was mentioning that they're rather extensive, and they are. Represent the Board of Selectmen in day-to-day town operations internally and externally to include directing town staff on behalf of the Board of Selectmen. Appoint and remove, supervise, and direct assigned as administrative staff, assist with interviews, make recommendations for filling department, board, committee vacancies, attend all meetings of the Board of Selectmen as well as town meeting, develop Board of Selectmen meeting agendas and town meeting warrants and related background materials, serve as chief procurement officer, responsible for information technology plans, acquisition, maintenance, and control, develop and administer human resource policies and practices, develop and oversee our annual operating budget, assist the Board of Selectmen in coordinating activities of all town departments, boards, offices, and committees, maintain records of the financial and administrative activity of the Board of Selectmen, oversee and administer the town energy program, serve as liaison and approve staff board committee requests for town council support, serve as focal point for grants, represent the Selectmen on the Emergency Management Committee and others as designated, oversee, direct, and supervise the cable TV function, keep the Board of Selectmen informed of the needs of the town and recommend measures regarding action by the board. Keep the board informed of recurring reports and significant upcoming events. Supervise the town accountant. Coordinate the annual financial audit. And we need something in there about overseeing management of the license, liquor license issuance. All right, well. Is there a motion to adopt this as kind of as a working document, and then we'll continue to refine it?
So moved.
I don't have a problem with adopting this,
okay?
What I have a problem potentially with is it gets buried, and we never really solve the overall situation, which is, to me, is chain of command, and that's what clearly needs to be defined. But I will second the motion to get the process started.
Okay.
I have no problem with that whatsoever.
Okay. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
And I guess I should have said this. Did you have any issue with anything on there?
No, and, okay. And I guess honestly, pretty much I'm
you're doing
it.
Okay.
But my suspicion is there may be a question here or there, legitimate question amongst staff members that, you know, to whom are they responsible to? And this clearly defines the position of the board regarding that question. And so therefore, if there's a situation where there's a strong disagreement, then they come through you to us.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? Yeah, not directly to us, but through you. So we have the players before us, and if it's an executive session issue or concern, so be it. We go into executive session. But this is a piece, I believe, has been missing, that a clearly defined functional role for the town administrator in terms of answering to the Board of Selectmen and how we view his or her role, in this case, her role.
There's a kind of a continuum from town secretary, town administrator, town manager. We're not at a town manager yet. We're back at town administrator. We're in that in-between. Now, it's clear when a town manager because all the departments report to the town manager, period. Not so in a town with a town administrator function. So we're not there yet. We're kind of in between. It gets to be a little gray sometime. We're trying to help, as you say here, clarify these roles and interfaces.
But as town administrator for us,
absolutely.
The Board of Selectmen,
yes.
Do you have any questions, or do we cover the concerns about responsibility and answerability, if you will, of subordinate staff?
What this doesn't do is I guess, you know, provide the details, some of the details that I'm looking for. There have been some, you know, circumstances or situations that have occurred, and, you know, I clearly understand what my role is, but, you know, again, I'm looking for clarification. And if, you know, for example, if there's a department head that is going to be out of the office, if I could just so I know that, you know, because there may be somebody, a resident or another department looking for
or a contractor or 100 other people.
Exactly.
Are you comfortable with the wording of what we're trying to establish here, where it's clearly defined that the answerability to us comes through you?
Yes.
Okay. That's all I'm concerned about. This is a clearly defined role. And there's no question on our part. Now, if something develops down the road, mm-hmm. then there's an avenue for that to be dealt with.
Sure.
And if it involves personnel, it can be dealt with, can it not,
sure.
in executive session. Fine. I'm just trying to minimize the potential problem areas that you may have to
I just wasn't sure, Pat, if you were uncomfortable with some of these things and that
no,
you
not
felt
at all.
That
absolutely
it really
not.
Should lie with the Board of Selectmen.
Motion
that
to
you
accept.
Want.
Serious.
I already did it.
You seconded it.
I'll second it. Pardon me.
All in favor?
I was
too busy.
All right. And just come back to us if we can clarify something further or add further.
Sure.
Or...
No, I...
Okay.
I pretty much have a handle on this. I have a handle on. I just wanted to make sure that Pat didn't feel that there were roles or responsibilities being taken away from the selectmen.
No.
And,
no. Okay. No. Not at all.
It's just the opposite
to us.
I am.
And so.
Bottom line.
Why would
I
be concerned?
Okay.
You can't get rid of us.
If that weren't the case, then we'd have a problem. We really, at least I would. Okay. Clearly gets taken care of. Excuse me. I belabor the point. I'm sorry.
Go ahead, Brian. Take charge.
That concludes everything that I had for discussion.
Old business.
Oh, yes, we do have old business, right. That concludes the administrator's report. Let me just go back to the agenda here. Okay. Just IT support and usage, you know, I'm still exploring, looking at that, and I didn't have all my information ready for this meeting. Just letting you know, updating human resource manual, that is something that is in the works, and I still have to get to that and present any recommended changes or additions to the HR policy.
Go ahead.
Didn't we wrap that up? We just got close to the end and never made the final.
You know what happened? Final,
we were doing it by sections.
Some years ago, Marlene, Louise, and I sat down and wrote it because it couldn't get done.
We did. we did. And actually, wasn't that a charge?
And this is what's going to happen, I think, again, because this has dribbled on for another couple of years.
But what I'm saying is we were going through this over the last year.
Oh, you have, sir?
Section
oh, okay.
by section.
Oh,
to
I didn't
make.
It
needs to be packaged
yes,
up again.
Yes, it needs to be
thrown
packaged.
Out to us.
Okay.
To,
but don't reinvent the wheel either.
And at some point vetted with our town attorney, particularly with the updates on personnel law.
I didn't realize you had been going through it section by section, so you have made some changes?
Some.
Okay.
We made some headway. I mean, you know, I just hate you to spend time on something that we might have in our minutes from we'd begun the process.
You know what we could do? Section by section over time. Throw a section at us and any proposed changes.
That's helpful. I didn't realize that.
Is this subject to town meeting approval or is this within our purview?
It's
within our responsibility.
The purview of Board of Selectmen. Yeah, I can research the minutes. Well, there is documents on file, and I can see where.
But I don't know how updated, I don't know when the last administrator made the updates or if it was just, because at each meeting we'd take a cut at it.
Okay.
At a various section.
Okay. All right.
All right, next. Dragon property?
The dragon property, as we know, that will be complete. One other item I didn't add there under old business is the Mohawk Communications Report. I had stated at the previous meeting that what I did locate on file in the office was what appears to be an inventory list. Okay. And I'm looking for a report with recommendations. Mm-hmm. I am meeting with Ray Sullivan from Mohawk Communications tomorrow. But I did ask if there was a report, I'd like it in advance of that meeting, but I have not received it.
Oh, no.
And for new business, unanticipated new business, the town accountant and I met with a representative from Verizon Wireless today. And we're reviewing the existing wireless phones that the town has. And I've asked the representative to put together a proposal for wireless phones for the fire chief, police chief, and lieutenant, police department, lieutenant of the police department. And I have not committed to anything, but it seems appropriate that they would have.
Even bringing it up, unless you mentioned it, you discovered that certain of our accounts were not government accounts, therefore we were paying too much.
Right.
So just Marlene's looking at it and talking to the right people have uncovered some potential cost savings for us.
The only wireless account the police department has is for two tablets, which are in the police cruisers. And it was discovered that those are not set up as government accounts. Profiles were never created. So that is going to be done so we can get the appropriate discount. And
have you guys spoken to the school department to see if they are or
well she did mention
part of the...
she looked and could see that the school department does have an account. It's one wireless account, and that is for the athletic director, and that is set up as a federal account. So she says it looks like it's been in place for quite some time.
And are they only looking for the administrators, if you will, to be part of that? Or will they ultimately offer up some sort of discounts to town employees? Is that a whole different thing as government employees?
Any any town employee who has a cell phone, if they're not, they are entitled to a discount.
Yeah, good.
So we'll get that message out. Actually,
get the chiefs up first, and then, yeah.
Is that specific to full-time or part-time as well?
You know, Pat, I'm not sure if that is specific to...
Is there a lot of, I know for a fact, emergency service people who rely heavily on the cell phone?
I bet you it's part-time, to be honest, but I don't know that as a fact, but...
I haven't a clue, so I just throw it out so that we include everybody.
Good question.
Right, they just look for proof of employment. They want to see your most recent pay stub, so I don't think it matters whether you're part-time or full-time. There is another option that is becoming available, and Verizon Wireless is working with some communities in the Berkshires, and they're working with the city of Northampton. And she will send me the literature, and this is a fleet management proposal. It's to track your vehicle's fuel, and also it can provide you with diagnostic reports, so if there's any problems that a vehicle may be, you know, incurring, it'll let you know. That cost is $19 a month per vehicle. And I told her I'm not sure at this point that that's something we would entertain. I said, we'll look at it, but I would want to have a conversation with the DPW director about it.
Okay. Anything else?
That is all I have.
Any other business, Pat?
Are we going to come back to this?
We did it.
Oh, did we miss something?
No. We covered it.
Okay, we'll talk about it.
Yeah.
No, I have nothing else.
All right, motion to adjourn?
So moved.
Second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Oh, all Marlene.